Blackstone presents Doppelganger Danger by Rebecca Caprara. This book is read by Sura Siu. For Mia, Isla, and Hunter, Nita's nieces and most cosmic cousins. Chapter 1. Dev Khatri's rules for surviving the multiverse were pretty simple. Speak up, act out, and kick some serious butt. These were the exact opposite of his rules for surviving middle school back in Ohio, where most people knew him as a quiet and nerdy band geek who avoided confrontation at all costs. But that life felt a world, no, worlds away. He glanced around at the parched, crumbling landscape. It was drained of color, like an old sepia-toned photograph, without the nostalgia or charm. Behind him, a steel and glass building sagged sadly, most of its windows shattered, its halls and labs empty. The faded NASA sign above the front doors hung at a crooked angle. Rusted cars littered the road, parked haphazardly and forgotten, as though people had been in a hurry to escape. Dev couldn't help but wonder, what had happened in this place before he and his friends arrived? Why did it look so apocalyptic? What had the people been running from? Far in the distance, yellow lights blinked and smokestacks coughed up noxious plumes. Ash floated through the air, stinging Dev's eyes. Blackened vines snaked through the cracked concrete at his feet. He exchanged a worried look with Maeve, who was putting on a brave face and leading them toward the eerie city in the valley below. Louis, Tessa, and Isaiah followed, their gazes set on the horizon, each lost in their own thoughts. The wind whispered and the vines at their feet writhed and twisted. A tendril wrapped itself around Dev's ankle. He kicked it away and quickened his pace, his heart beating hard. None of this was right. He and his friends weren't supposed to be here. They had tried to travel home, where their families were waiting for them back on Earth in Dimension 14. Their Earth, this parallel place, was definitely not it. Dev exhaled, shaking off his fears and steeling himself for whatever lay ahead. There was no doubt about it. In the past few days, everything had changed, himself included. It all started when Dev and his fellow marching bandmates, the Conroy Cadets, accidentally activated a quantum collider during a class field trip to the Gwen Research Center, a NASA field station where Dev's father worked as a catastrophysicist. The collider transported them to Station Liminus, a central meeting place between dimensions, governed by the Multiverse Allied Council. As if stumbling into a new dimension and meeting a dazzling array of sentient lifeforms hadn't been mind-blowing enough, the cadets then learned that Earth was on the brink of collapse. Oh, and the Mac, mistaking the cadets for an envoy of Earth's best and brightest, expected the kids to fix everything. No pressure, right? In the past, Dev had worried about normal middle school stuff like pop quizzes, body odor, and embarrassing himself in front of his crush. After arriving on Station Liminus, those past worries seemed silly by comparison, especially when the cadets realized the fate of their home planet and the entire multiverse rested in their well-intentioned but rather clumsy hands. Thrust into uncertainty and peril, the cadets rose to the occasion as best they could, using their musical talents to reestablish contact with Queen Erina, a powerful and important ally. In addition, they thwarted duplicitous General Shro, unmasked Dr. Genevieve Scopes as a traitor, and revealed the Empyrean One's malevolent plans for destruction and domination. Not too shabby for a bunch of middle school misfits who'd previously been frequent victims of the school bully's supersonic atomic bubonic wedgie attacks. Sure, the cadets had made some pretty epic mistakes along the way, disrupting interdimensional diplomacy, damaging critical gateways, and setting loose a seriously scary space beast, to name a few. But overall, Dev was proud of himself and his friends. Garoor! Uh-oh, speaking of space beasts. Dev, Tessa, Isaiah, Maeve, and Louis wheeled around and instinctively huddled together, each one facing outward, eyes wide and watching. Krarg! Something resembling the long-lost cousin of the Colossodon crashed through the nearby forest, toppling the blackened trees like toothpicks. The cadets froze. The beast lurched forward, nostrils flaring. What is that? Tessa whimpered, moving closer to Dev, her arm brushing against.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.